Hi friends, wishing all of you, that is today, the 29th July 2020, a happy lipstick day. Well, so I'm here today. I'm so excited about this day today and I felt like sharing a few things about my lipstick kitty with all of you. So today is celebrated as a National Lipstick Day. So on this day, I would suggest you all wear your color, wear whatever you like and just flaunt it. On this eve, I would like to share a few collections of mine that I have that I would like to show. Yes, and these are all from different brands. And well, there's something more to this also. Ta-da! So, the purpose of showing all this is basically just to give a few tips on the wearing your lipstick. Today we have so many brands around us and also the form of lipstick that we wear also comes in a different modes. That is, some are the typical stick forms, some are the crayons, some are the liquid forms, and believe me, all are beautiful. The versatility of wearing a lipstick depends on the brand, but it also depends on what occasion and what time of hour you are wearing it. So let me show you a few things about this. Being an Indian, I always prefer a few good Indian brands, mainly Lakme, which actually suits your lips very well. Apart from this, I also prefer some brands which are like Chambord, then Faces, Revlon, and also some imported brands like MAC, Ignalt. They are simply superb because the texture and the finish that they give upon application is amazing. So, whenever you want to have a little subtle look, you can always prefer the nudes or the lighter shade. And when you want to make a little kind of a bold statement, you can always prefer a little darker shade. So today that I'm wearing is something in the browns, and let me show you. So this is a lip liner, a brown one, which I have used today, which is of Chambord, and along with this I have paired for the inner part with a stick form from Ignalt. So this is absolutely a matte finish and it gives a very subdued and yet a flat look on your lips when you actually want a bright or a bold color yet a little subdued look. So if you are a person who is more on outdoors for your work requirement like the way I am, so you should prefer to use the brands which provide the liquid lipsticks, because they stay for a longer time and you really don't have to bother much for a touch-up or something like that till the evening. So some of the good brands that I use and prefer are something like from MAC. This is from Sephora. Something from Chambord. The Body Shop. This is also absolutely a good texture and good finish brand. Ignalt, and this is of course the Color Bar. So there are so many brands around us and you can choose the, you know, the ones which actually suit your lip color and your complexion. So it is just a matter of little trial and error, and upon which you can decide which color suits you the best. Remember guys, whenever you want to give a little more defined look to your lips, I always prefer to start with a lip liner. So when I say ki I prefer the liquid matte lipsticks, there are a few challenges you face while applying the product. So I would be sharing you two or three tips so that you don't overdo or over apply the product on your lips. So firstly, tip number one, whenever you are wanting to use a matte lipstick, always precondition your lips with a Vaseline or a creamy product so that you can keep your lips a bit moist. Secondly, it is always difficult to apply a liquid lipstick directly as it tends to dry up faster. So the best way is to define or give a certain shape to your lips prior to the actual application. So whenever you give a defined shape to your lips with a lip liner, always start from the middle and then start from the center towards the ends of your lips. That will give you a better idea to give an equal look to both your upper as well as your lower lips. And thirdly, then when you proceed to apply your actual, say, liquid product, do not use or pick up a lot of this product as it tends to give a patchy look after application. So lesser the better, especially in case of a liquid lipstick. And lastly, but not the least, removal of a matte lipstick from the lips is absolutely essential as it tends to adhere to your lips, you know, more firmer, and hence it becomes a little more difficult to even erase it. For this, you again need to apply a Vaseline or a cream conditioner to your lips. Just let it remain for, you know, a minute or two, and then using a clean cotton or a tissue, you can easily remove off the product from your lips. Always remember, the way you apply, the way it is important to apply a product properly, it is equivalently important to remove the makeup product from your face in an appropriate manner. So, for me, lipstick is the only makeup element which I just cannot afford to miss whenever I'm stepping out of my house. It actually kind of changes my mood and, you know, it gives a certain facelift as soon as you apply it, that fresh look. So friends, wishing you all once again happy lipstick day, encouraging you all to wear your favorite lip color. Let your lips speak.